Hello guys, here with a new video for the channel. I hope you like it, and if you like it, don't forget to leave your powerful like supreme god level, comment, and subscribe. Now without further ado, get comfortable. Let's begin. All this history would begin in the final battle of the Tournament of Power, where the last two warriors would be giving a great battle. They were the Saiyan Son Goku from Universe 7, and the mortal who exceeded all his limits, Jiren. They were giving a battle very close. However, when Son Goku was about to take Jiren off the platform, he collapsed and fell to the ground, leaving Jiren surprised. All this would remain the same until the end of the tournament, where before making the wish to the great god dragon Zarma, the great Daishinkan priest of a powerful and accurate attack will leave the great Zeno-sama on the verge of death, where his guardians only observed what happened. All the others would be shocked to witness the betrayal of the great Daishinkan before Zeno-sama. At that moment, the Daishinkan was going to kill everyone. However, the Zeno-sama of the future launched himself to attack him, but Daishinkan would exterminate him with a great attack.
I've been training for this moment. I won't let you ruin my plans, you damn dwarf.
Daishinkan was about to exterminate everyone present. However, the present Zeno-sama would stand up very injured, and with his last reserves of power, he would rise into the air to say the following.
You won't get away with this. You will soon pay for all this.
In his mind, he would tell Goku and Vegeta,
You are the salvation of this universe, so this will happen again. I'll use a forbidden technique that will allow me to turn back time. You'll keep your powers, and with the passage of time, you will even be able to overcome my power.
Zeno-sama would launch an attack towards Goku and Vegeta, disappearing instantly, while the Guardian Angels would be very amazed, wanting to help Zeno-sama.
Don't move! Absolute paralysis!
Daishinkan approaches Zeno-sama with a cold look.
Great Zeno-sama, your aim is failing. Instead of erasing me, you erased your only friend in the Saiyan Vegeta. You should never have ruled this universe. You're practically a child.
Daishinkan would turn his back on Zeno, whereupon Zeno-sama would quickly stand up.
Total override!
Upon hearing those words, Daishinkan wanted to stop him, but it was too late. The High Priest would have trusted himself. Total cancellation. It's a technique that allows you to cancel everything created and return the years that the bearer wishes. Everything was a restart in the multiverse. Everyone present would forget that event, except for the Dragon Priest, who was furious, realizing that he was in the King's Palace from 25 years ago. However, he began to smile.
But if the useless Zeno-sama sacrificed himself, that means that in this age, there shouldn't be a king of everything. Thanks, dwarf. You've made things much easier.
However, without Daishinkan expecting it, someone would have released a great power. Daishinkan noticed the great attack, and at that last moment, he was able to dodge it.
Who the hell are you? Don't you know who I am?
Daishinkan would watch the Guardians.
No one can enter the Palace of Everything except a high-powered divine being.
But what happens to you, great Daishinkan priest? Did you hit your head or something? She is...
At that time, a girl would say, You two shut up! For me, it's better that you don't remember who I am, so you won't hold back. Daishinkan, without understanding anything, would raise a part of his power by throwing a strong blow, which the girl would stop with one hand. Daishinkan would be astonished since he would have used 60% in his blow. He began to raise all his power in an incredible way, and with her power, she would give him a great blow. And there was no change. That's right, the girl stopped him with one hand, just the same. Daishinkan, without giving up, would deliver a shrapnel of blows, which the girl dodged with no difficulty. Daishinkan was able to land one of her blows that would send her crashing into the palace. The guardians were shocked.
Great Nemesis-sama.
This one would come out with a big smile.
That blow has caused me a little damage.
Queen of Everything, are you all right?
Dyshaken, upon hearing what the guards said, would be shocked. He approached and apologized.
How boring. The fun is over. Good priest, clean up all the mess.
Dyshaken would obey, and he would say to himself,
Zeno-sama was so powerful as to go back in time, and at that same time create a true queen of everything. Hopefully these guardians are easy to dominate so they can betray her.
Meanwhile, on a faraway planet, to be more exact, on the planet Vegeta, two Saiyans would have been born with surprising power. Surpassing most of the elite warriors on the planet, their parents, King Vegeta and Bardock, would be proud of them. These two Saiyans would say,
What happened? Where do we meet?
Why do our bodies feel so small?
Sometime later, the two Saiyans would come out of the incubator machines, going home, one to their home. The Saiyan Kakarot, with only 1 year of birth, was able to fly just like the Saiyan Vegeta. They knew that they had sealed their power and had to wake him up a little by little and take revenge on Dyshaken. However, 4 years would have passed where Dyshaken went to the planet of Beerus.
God of destruction of the universe 7, Beerus.
What a surprise, Father, that you are in this place. What is offered to you?
I have to talk to the god Beerus.
Oh, I see, of course. Let me wake him up because he's taking a nap.
Whis would wake up Beerus, who would get up very upset.
Who bothers the god of destruction?
However, at that moment, he observed Dyshaken begin to tremble.
I'm so sorry. Great Dyshaken-sama, tell me, how can I help you? You have a mission, Beerus. Destroy the planet of Vegeta of the Saiyans.
Of course, High Priest. Whatever you order.
Beerus would order the Emperor of Evil Frieza to annihilate the entire Saiyan race.
Of course, Great Beerus-sama. Whatever you say.
Meanwhile, on the planet Vegeta, Goku and Vegeta would have noticed that they were gathering all the Saiyans, and they would know what Frieza was up to. Meanwhile, in the atmosphere of the planet, Bardock was fighting against Frieza's army. Frieza, observing how all his warriors fell, he left his ship, creating a great supernova, while Bardock would create a spiritual cannon, but it would not be enough. Meanwhile, Goku, who was with Vegeta, observing and feeling the attack, teleported in front of him. Bardock disappearing the attack in one blow, everyone would be surprised, since a child's son would disappear the great attack of the great Frieza with a simple blow. Goku would take a step forward.
I will not allow you to destroy this Frieza planet.
Goku and Vegeta would go Super Saiyan, causing all the trackers to explode, causing everyone to tremble.
I'll take care of him, Kakarot.
Knowing that Goku's power was no match for Vegeta's, Goku would de-transform.
Go to your last form, damn insect, if you don't want me to kill you in one hit.
Frieza, frightened, would go into his last form, lodging himself into the attack. The collision of both was overwhelming. That's right, the clash of their fists made the entire planet of Vegeta tremble. After a few moments in which Vegeta was controlling the entire battle, Frieza, he would have realized that he was not even with his last form was a match for the Vegeta Prince.
In a few years, we'll need you. Meanwhile, in that flower park that you hate so much.
Vegeta would charge a great final blow, throwing it at Frieza, eliminating him, leaving no trace of it at all. All the Saiyans would praise Goku and Vegeta, telling them that they were the Super Saiyans of the legend. Goku would help his father, taking him to a recovery capsule. They would continue training. However, in the palace of everything, Dyshaken, it would be said,
Damn, how can I make that pair of guards betray that damn? I can see how they are much more afraid and respectful of her than Zeno-sama's dwarf.
Dyshaken would also realize that the Queen Nemesis-sama controlled her power 100% of her, and not only depended on the erase ability, but that she had a strength that surpassed any warrior in any universe.
That stupid queen controls all her power, so it'll be much more difficult for me. Because if I attack her, she'll exterminate me in the blink of an eye.
Dyshaken would put on a cold look.
Zeno-sama, you have won a battle but not the war. You have created an authentic queen of everything.
Meanwhile, on the planet Vegeta, everyone was still amazed by the power that both Saiyans showed when they were just children. Time later, the Saiyan Bardock would have recovered from all his injuries and was training. At that moment, Goku would approach.
Father, could you train with me, please? I want to become much more powerful.
Of course not, Kakarot. You're still a child. I could kill you with one blow.
Bardock wouldn't know everything that had happened since he had been knocked unconscious when Frieza fired his supernova at him. However, after insisting so much, Goku managed to convince Bardock, who would agree to train with him.
Okay, then let's have a friendly father and son fight!
Goku began to raise his power a bit, leaving his father surprised.
Kakarot, I've always wondered how you got so much power.
The fight would begin. Goku was obviously holding back too much, giving him a few blows that would only hurt him a little. 14 years would have passed since the Tournament of Power. They already dominated the Super Saiyan Blue and also 25% of the egotistical doctrine when Goku turned 15. He spoke to his father, telling him everything he had lived, telling him that the moment of the Battle of Tournament of Power until the High Priest betrayed them. Bardock would then be surprised by everything said by Kakarot.
Is my son a god? I can't believe it.
That's right, father. Vegeta and I are on par with the gods of destruction, and we can be considered Saiyan gods.
After a few more months, both warriors would have already reached their maximum power as mortals. But nevertheless, Zeno-sama left his power to them, being able to rise from the lowest mortal ground to the highest divine ground, surpassing gods, angels, and kings. However, they were still trained. Meanwhile, in the Palace of Everything, the Queen Nemesis was very bored, so she decided to take a walk through all the universes and doing a review at all. When Nemesis was Universe 7, she felt two extremely powerful keys, which surprised his gods and his angels. Flashback, Goku and Vegeta had teleported to an inhospitable planet so as not to cause damage to the rest of the universe. They created a barrier so that they could not feel their powers, but the Nemesis was much more powerful and had greater perception to feel the key. This one could feel them. And a flashback. Nemesis would teleport to said planet where she would observe two warriors with silver hair and opposing gray eyes that showed authority. Both Saiyans, noticing her, would stop their training.
Who are you? Can we help you with something?
Who are you, damn insect? Can't you see we're training? We could finish you off with one of our attacks.
Observing that the subjects did not know who she was and spoke to her normally, Nemesis would become interested in them, to which, without giving notice to anyone, she would launch herself at the speed of light, which even Vegeta with perfect Ultra Instinct was not able to dodge an accurate blow that would have given him. Nemesis would have given the Prince of the Saiyans a powerful blow, which would send him flying a few meters. Goku would be surprised by the power of that blow. While the Queen of Everything, Nemesis, would think that she had killed that warrior because a normal god would have died.
I finished with your friend. Now it's your turn.
At that moment, Goku would be on guard.
Don't think we're so easy to beat. That attack hasn't managed to exterminate Vegeta.
Vegeta would come out of the rubble at maximum speed, and with surprising power, he would launch himself into the attack. Throwing a blow at him, the Nemesis Queen managed to stop that blow. However, she was surprised. This, she would say to herself,
these guys are not normal. With the blow I gave him, I didn't want to kill him, I just knocked him out. But not this guy. Any god, angel, or even my guardians would have been knocked out, but not this warrior.
Observing how that woman had stopped his blow with one hand, Vegeta would be surprised. Seeing how in his most powerful form he could stop his attack, Queen Nemesis would raise his power a little by giving him a blow that would leave him unconscious. But the power that he had used, it was absurdly surprising that even she was surprised. Goku, realizing this, would raise all his power to full power Ultra Instinct.
Get ready. I can see that you have great power, so I won't trust myself.
Goku would launch the attack, giving him a bit more of a fight than he vegetates. Nemesis would realize that this warrior was much more powerful than the one he just defeated. Goku, using all his power, however, was not able to give him an accurate blow. Since it hit and dodged, his Ultra Instinct was on another level, being able to even neutralize key collisions.
I don't know who you are, but you are much more powerful than me. But I don't understand why you don't attack me if you wanted to. You would.
You're very strange, but if it is what you want, I hope you support it.
Nemesis would teleport in front of Goku, and at this, a maximum speed gave him a strong blow. He thought he had won. However, at the bottom of the crater, he watches as said warrior stood up once more. Nemesis, seeing the resistance, would ask about this.
What is your name? I'd like to know the names of subjects of great power.
My name's Goku, but I'm known as Kakarot.
You have been the most powerful rival I've faced, but you lack power.
This is not my full power.
Nemesis would be surprised by what the Saiyan said. This can't be true. How is it possible that a mortal has more power than a god, or even more power than my guardians?
At that precise moment, Goku began to raise his power in a surprising way, and raising it rapidly, making everything around him tremble.
Nemesis would be shocked to feel how this Saiyan managed to overcome the power of his guardians, destroying it a bit of the planet where they were.
Kaioken increased 100 times!
At that moment, everything began to shake. Nemesis was only able to see a red flash, and a second later, she was thrown into a mountain with brutal force. Goku would continue with his attack. However, from one moment to the next, Nemesis stopped one of his blows, or the smile would tell him,
"It was a good warm-up. You are the second being that makes me use 25% of all my power."
Goku was surprised, since he could not believe that said woman is only using 25% of her power.
"Who the hell are you? How do you have such amazing power?"
Nemesis increased his power to 30%. With one accurate blow, he would be knocked out.
"You better not know where my power comes from."
Nemesis threw a sphere of ki at Goku and Vegeta, going to the Palace of Everything. Said sphere would enter the body of the Saiyans, curing them of all their injuries. After a few hours, both would realize they were alone. However, Vegeta would be furious, knowing that a woman would have humiliated him like that and defeating him with a single blow.
"Vegeta, that woman must be a super goddess of destruction, since she uses the Kaioken increased 100 times, and that this, she said, only used 25% of her power."
Vegeta would be surprised. However, a voice would resound in the heads of both Saiyans.
"You are Goku and Vegeta. You've been reborn with the help of Zeno-sama, since you are the hope of this multiverse."
Goku and Vegeta would be confused and a little surprised by what was said.
"I'm the creator of the Super Dragon Spheres, the god Zarma, and I've come to offer you strong training since I can observe in one of my premonitions how this entire multiverse falls into annihilation. And even the queen of all Nemesis is no match for those warriors."
Goku and Vegeta, realizing that the situation was life or death, and knowing they would become much stronger, they would accept. Meanwhile, in the Kingdom of Everything, Nemesis would have returned the Great Priest together with his guardians, would have realized that this he had a great battle when observing his destroyed clothes. Daishinkan would be shocked to learn that somewhere in the 12 universes, there was such a powerful warrior, capable of hurting Nemesis a little. So Daishinkan would be thoughtful.
"If a warrior was able to leave her Nemesis like that, I can't imagine what he would do to me. He would pulverize me since using all my power. I wasn't able to even scratch him."
Daishinkan would begin with an arduous training in a special room. On the other hand, in a dimension far removed from the 12 universes, to be more exact, in the world of the immortal gods, there were Goku and Vegeta. However, they did not know anything. They only felt the power of beings of overwhelming ki. At that moment, a subject appeared with an appearance very similar to Piccolo.
"I am God Zarma, the one in charge of training you. The great Zeno-sama gave his powers and his life so that you could be saved."
Goku and Vegeta, realizing this subject knew everything that had happened, agreed to go with him. Zarma would tell them everything that had happened in that multiverse on the way.
"You guys just fought the new queen of everything, Nemesis."
Goku and Vegeta would be shocked to learn that they had fought the queen of everything.
"We have arrived. Now, without beginning the strongest training you've ever had, so get ready, since in this room the kings train at all."
Goku and Vegeta entered said room, but the moment they did, a strong gravity would crush them.
"I thought they were stronger. Zeno-sama gave his life for insects like you."
At that moment, a subject would come out.
"Long time no see, Kakarot and Prince Vegeta."
Goku and Vegeta couldn't tell who he was since this guy had a mask.
"I see you have grown quite a lot, Vegeta.
the same prince would recognize that voice.
Father, what are you doing here? Weren't you on the Vegeta planet?
Zarma would get into the conversation.
Your father is indeed on the planet Vegeta, but this Vegeta King is a dimensional warrior. But there was a failure in this time after the death of Zeno-sama. Some powerful warriors have returned.
Among them two are the most dangerous and are the evil counterparts. One is Dark Vegeta, who in his timeline murdered all the gods, but was sealed by Zeno-sama, while evil Goku was in his timeline, did the same. Both met in said dimensions and became death companions, becoming stronger and stronger. Zeno-sama doesn't erase things, he just seals them in dimensional portal, and if Zeno-sama from any timeline dies, everything that was once sealed will return, and no one can prevent that. So those two guys are loose from the multiverse. To my knowledge, not even Nemesis can stop them.
That's right. That's why we train to be rivals for that guy.
Goku and Vegeta, upon hearing that the new villains were themselves, were surprised.
If it's to protect the 12 universes that Zeno-sama commissioned us, we'll do it.
If the Kakarot insect thinks it'll come back stronger, I won't be left behind.
At that time, all the warriors would begin training in said room. Meanwhile, outside that place, in Universe 7, King Cold would have arrived in search of revenge. Flashback, one of Frieza's soldiers was able to survive and he communicated with King Cold, informing him that some Saiyans that changed their hair color defeated Frieza. King Cold would arrive at planet Vegeta, destroying everything in his path. At that moment, King Vegeta and Bardock would face King Cold.
Who were the bastards that killed my son?
He was the Prince of the Saiyans, my son.
Furious King Cold would launch the attack to which both Saiyans would begin to have a great battle against. After a couple of moments, the three subjects were injured.
This is not all my power. That's right, I can transform too.
King Cold would go into his last form using 50% of all his power, beating both warriors, leaving them very badly injured. However, from one moment to another that both got rid of their attacks, they transformed into Super Saiyan. Since their children had told them how to do it, the three warriors started again with a great fight, where the Saiyans would be putting King Cold in trouble. That's right, King Cold would use all his power, beginning on par again.
The Saiyan race is the most powerful in the entire universe. Receive this spiritual cannon!
King Vegeta would not be left behind, also carrying a powerful attack in the palm of his hands. At that moment, King Cold would try to stop that great attack, but it was impossible. This was reduced to atoms. The two Saiyans would fall very injured to the ground and de-transformed. Both were reaching in recovery capsules. Meanwhile, in the palace of the Queen of Everything was the Queen Nemesis, thinking about the Saiyans' son Goku that made him use 25% of all his power. She wondered,
could it be that the warrior has become much more powerful than the last time?
She would decide to go look for him to ask him for another fight. Since she had so much fun, she left the king's palace completely going to look for him. However, Daishenken found himself in a room to be able to exceed his limits and be able to kill the Queen of Everything, Nemesis. On the other hand, the Queen of Everything had arrived on the planet Vegeta.
Do two Saiyans with silver hair like their eyes live on this planet?
The only ones who knew about this power were King Vegeta and Bardock, since his sons had told him everything that had happened. They knew that this girl was looking for them.
Why are you looking for those Saiyans?
You look like them. Are you their parents?
Both Saiyans would affirm what the Queen said completely.
Now tell me, where are both Saiyans?
Both Saiyans would refuse to answer. The Queen of Everything, Nemesis, would start to rage.
If you don't tell me where the Saiyans are, I swear, I will kill them and destroy this entire universe.
Nemesis would be expelling a great power because the Saiyans refused to tell them where the Saiyans were. Meanwhile, on the planet of the Destroyer God Beerus, Whis would have awakened Beerus from his deep sleep.
Whis, if you woke me up for some stupid thing, I will destroy at least a solar system.
Sir Beerus, the Queen of Everything, Nemesis-sama, is in our universe, to be more exact, is in the planet Vegeta of the Saiyans.
Beerus would be shocked.
What? What did you just say, Whis? Is the Queen of Everything found in our humble universe? Let's go right away in case those damn monkeys make her angry and destroy this whole universe.
Beerus and Whis would leave at full speed to the planet of the Saiyans. However, when they arrived, they only observed how everything was being destroyed little by little, where the King Vegeta and Bardock observed Beerus. He was glad.
Sir Beerus, please help us.
Upon hearing that name, Nemesis would turn to see him. At that moment, Beerus would bow, and the Vegeta King, together with Bardock, would be surprised to see how the destroyer god of this universe had so much respect for that girl. They were terrified to hear that Beerus would say,
"It gives me an honor to have her in our humble universe, Queen of Everything, Nemesis-sama."
Everyone would still tremble at what this one would have said.
"Destroyer god Beerus, I'm looking for two Saiyans that made me use 25% of all my power."
Beerus and Whis, upon hearing this, would be shocked, since they couldn't believe how some Saiyans made the Queen use so much power.
"I don't think that's possible.
Don't you believe my word?"
At that moment, Beerus would be speechless with terror.
"It is very difficult to believe that a mortal surpasses the power of a god of destruction, much less that mortals have surpassed the powers of an angel, and being on par with 25% of all their power. If those Saiyans do not arrive in 24 hours, I'll destroy this entire universe, including you, Beerus."
Everyone started looking for both Saiyans.
"What do I do now, Whis? I don't think I'll find anyone who makes Nemesis-sama use 25% of her full power."
After 24 hours, where Nemesis would return to the planet Vegeta, and when he observed that the Saiyans were not there, he would have become enraged.
"I gave them 24 hours to find them! So now, I have no other option but to exterminate them!"
Beerus and everyone would ask for mercy for their life. However, the Queen of Everything, Nemesis, would charge a large sphere of ki with the ability to erase. Just as about that large attack was about to hit, all two silhouettes would appear in front of that attack, disintegrating it. Nemesis would not understand what had happened. Without giving it much importance, it would reload an attack with much more power, to which the same thing would happen, and a voice would be heard.
"So you want to destroy my planet, Nemesis? Then I won't let you!"
Flashback, Goku and Vegeta would continue training. At that moment, a signal would reach Zarma, stopping the training.
"Something bad happens in Universe 7. The Queen of Everything, Nemesis, is on the planet Vegeta and wants to fight and is about to destroy the planet."
Goku, feeling the power of that attack, will teleport next to Vegeta, appearing in front of that great attack. Everyone was surprised at how she had stopped that attack. Even Beerus and Whis couldn't move due to the pressure of their ki. Goku would return to see Nemesis with a Nemesis look that would make her shudder a bit and would say,
"What is this feeling? My body says I'm in danger."
However, this, without following much of her instincts, would raise her power a bit.
"I am the Queen of Everything, and I can delete what I want."
"You can erase planets and universes, but let's see if you can erase a person."
At that moment, Goku would go on the attack at a flashing speed. Compared to the first time, this time the Nemesis Queen could not see anything. She only felt a powerful blow that would send her to the ground. Beerus and Whis were amazed at just being able to observe as the Queen of Everything would fall from a strong blow to the floor.
"What the hell? I was not able to see anything."
Nemesis would raise her power to 25% again and would attack the Saiyan. However, she would realize that she was being mocked, since the Saiyan only dodged and blocked the same blows without any difficulty. Nemesis, realizing this, would raise her power to 50%, giving him a big blow to the face. The Saiyan would return with it and a smile.
"That punch only tickled me."
Goku would launch a powerful kick that not even with 50% of her would be able to stop. She would fall at the feet of Beerus and Whis. They would try to help her. Annoying Nemesis would increase her power to 90%, making everything shake around her.
"I did not expect you to become so powerful in this short time, but now I will show you a power that you will never be able to reach."
"Are you sure, Nemesis? I'm only using 45% of all my power."
Everyone present would be in shock. Furious Nemesis would go on the attack. However, there was nothing to do. The Saiyan Son Goku had surpassed her by a lot. And on the other hand, in a very distant place, there were two Saiyans destroying planets and becoming more powerful. One of them would stop and observe the infinite universe.
"We've been hiding for a long time. It
It's time for the gods of this world to fall. I can feel an immense power millions of kilometers from here.
Calm down, Kakarot. We must know the power of all.
At that moment, they felt the clash of fists that destroyed everything, and they could get to where they were. Returning to the battlefield, the queen of all Nemesis was very injured. Furious, Nemesis, with the intention of killing, she would launch an attack with her erase ability. Goku would respond with a similar attack.
This is impossible! I'm the only one with the ability to erase!
Goku, at the moment of being able to explain everything, Daishinkan would arrive.
So you dirty mortals were reborn. You don't know what awaits you. I will make you suffer until I ask you to kill you.
Whis would have already cured the Queen of Everything Nemesis.
What the hell is going on here? What is this all about?
You are nothing more than a simple copy of Zeno-sama. You're not the true Queen of Everything. Only I deserve the title of King.
Furious, Nemesis would attack, where Daishinkan would parry his blow with one hand.
Now you are not a match for me.
Daishinkan, with a strong blow, would leave her lying on the floor. Goku was preparing to attack. However, the Saiyan Prince would go ahead of him, going to Perfect Ultra Instinct, throwing a big blow at Daishinkan, who was not able to observe said attack.
I see you're much more powerful than that stupid queen.
Daishinkan would raise all his power, making the entire multiverse tremble. The power that he realized was absurdly incredible, and at that moment, two lightning bolts began to clash their fists. Said battle would define the future of the entire multiverse. It could not be observed who would be the winner since both warriors were equal. Meanwhile, Goku would be with the Nemesis Queen, giving her a little bit of his power so that she can recover. At that moment, she opened her eyes. She would blush when she observed how the Saiyan had her in his arms. Meanwhile, Daishinkan would have taken the lead in the battle, giving Vegeta a few good blows that would fall badly injured. Goku observing this.
I see you've been training, but even so, you can't beat me. I'll exterminate you!
Goku would release immense power. Goku would go full power Ultra Instinct. Goku would launch into the first attack, beating the High Priest. That would have been fighting for a few hours. At one point in the battle, both would walk away.
You have raised your powers a lot, but I'm only using 65% of all my power.
Daishinkan would raise all the power of him, making everything around him tremble, and a few planets would be destroyed, making everything around him shake.
Well, I'm not using all my power either.
Goku begins to raise his power quickly, and his hair would grow to his waist. His appearance was imposing. All the universes would shake when feeling such power. The Queen of Everything Nemesis is surprised.
So that is the true power of Son Goku.
Whis and Beerus would be scared and could not move. Goku, at the end of his transformation, would have reached the powerful Ultra Instinct Phase 3. Everyone present could not believe such power. Whis and Beerus could not feel the power of Son Goku, but his terrible pressure, Goku would give Daishinkan a shrapnel of blows that would leave him lying on the ground, and he would charge a powerful Kamehameha that would make him ashes. Leaving no dust from the Great Priest, Whis would cure everyone, knowing that his father wanted to exterminate them and rule all the universes, while Goku and Vegeta would tell everything that happened to Beerus. Whis and the Queen of Everything Nemesis, everyone was surprised by what those Saiyans.
I understand why I was taken from my original palace.
Everyone wouldn't understand what she would say.
I'm not from this multiverse. I don't remember what multiverse I'm from.
At that moment, a voice would rumble through the place.
They are Goku and Vegeta. They must be attentive since soon their evil parts will arrive. King Vegeta is about to help them, but they must survive.
Goku and Vegeta told him that the god Zarma had told them about the death of a king of everything, and that two evil parts of themselves returned to them. From one moment to the next, a sinister power would appear, and two red eyes would they soon come to see.
So you are our good parts.
Everyone would be watching the two new enemies.
What do you want here? And what do you want? The only thing we want is to become the more powerful and exterminate all living beings in all 12 universes. We won't let you, damn insects!
Both Saiyans would go full power Ultra Instincts, however, their counterparts would laugh.
What a power so low that your damn worms, they won't even serve to warm up!
Goku would launch himself against Dark Vegeta, while Vegeta against Dark Goku. Everyone would be having a close battle, where both Saiyans would go Super Saiyan Rose, balancing the battle much more by giving themselves some good blows. The Queen of Everything wanted to do something, but no idea had enough power to do it. Whis and Beerus could not even move. At that moment, Dark Vegeta, observing this, would launch a very powerful sphere of energy. Goku would try to teleport to stop it, however, Dark Vegeta would not allow it. At that moment, the Queen would completely face that great attack using the erased power that was greater than hers. The attack would hit her squarely, causing a great explosion. Furious, Goku managed to raise his power much more, giving Vegeta a great blow that almost knocked him out. Going to help Nemesis, Goku would take her with Whis and create a field of energy for it to move.
"Leave this place! Go to the Kingdom of Everything and put barriers so that no one can enter."
Whis would obey and they would leave. Goku and Vegeta would be in trouble, where their counterparts would charge a final glow and a Kamehameha. Goku and Vegeta would try to counter them with the same technique, but the power of their enemies far exceeded them. The attack was about to collide with Goku and Vegeta. What will happen next? Find out in the next chapter. Well guys, this is all for today's chapter. I hope you liked it and it was to your liking. Now don't forget to leave your powerful like, supreme god level, comment, and subscribe. Now without further ado, see you in a new video. Until next time.